Chapter 3. Thoth. May 12, 2011. Rome. What was your relationship with Mrs. Hooper? What was it she wanted to show you? Where is the gun? Why did you kill her? Time and again, the same questions, for hours on end. He always gave the same answers, but they didn't seem to get tired because they saw how tired he was. At some point, they figured he would talk. Peter Adams sat at a table in a bleak interrogation room. Close behind him stood the younger of the two commissarios, taking turns questioning him, a pale guy in a blue vest. They had offered him coffee and cigarettes, but he'd declined both and just asked for some water. The entire time he saw Loretta in his mind's eye, Loretta lying in her own blood, the hole in her chest, the bloody sign on the floor, the fright in her eyes as she recognized him. Peter was desperately trying to understand what Loretta had meant by her last words. Which list existed? Propheria de Summis Pontificibus, Apocalypsis. However, what worried him most at this point was the statement from the hotel concierge. He claimed to have seen him not only shortly before the police arrived, but also 2 hours earlier. That can't be. It's simply not possible. But this was exactly the time that he couldn't recall, because there was a gaping hole of 4 hours in his memory. The police didn't believe his migraine story. Of course they didn't. In fact, they didn't believe a single word he said. I want to talk to a lawyer, he mumbled for the umpteenth time. Were you having an affair with Mrs. Hooper? Peter didn't answer. The young commissario behind him drew in a breath sharply through his teeth. It seemed to be a sort of tic. At that moment, the door opened and his older colleague entered the room with another man whom Peter hadn't seen before. A bullish, muscular guy with a shaven head. Early 50s, Peter guessed. The man took off his jacket and without further ado sat down at the table right in front of Peter. What now, the hard way? Peter asked in Italian. Urs Bueller, the man introduced himself in German. Commander of the Swiss Guards. Come on, this is completely out of your jurisdiction. Bueller didn't respond to that remark. What were you doing in the papal apartment last night? I've never been to the papal apartment. Bueller's jaw muscles twitched. Peter assumed that the man was itching to beat him up, but he controlled his temper and pushed a photograph towards Peter. It was a picture of the crime scene. Loretta's dead body. The three bloody numbers on the floor. The number in the middle was not clearly recognizable. It could have been 306 or 3x6. What does this mean? No idea. This is how I found Loretta. The first figure is a 3. The last figure is a 6. But what's that in the middle? A multiplication sign or what? 3x6? What does this mean? 666? The number of the beast? I've already told you I don't know. But you spent an awful lot of time with Padre Luigi. Perhaps you are possessed. Perhaps it wasn't actually you who killed Mrs. Hooper, but your demon. Perhaps you will even get away with it. This is ridiculous. Suddenly, Bueller leaned towards Peter. No, it is far from it, Mr. Adam, he hissed at him. You are a murderer and you broke into the papal apartment. I want to know why. I want to know everything, even if I have to tear you a new asshole to get it out of you. Peter looked up at the two commissarios. Bueller shook his head. Forget it. Unfortunately, they don't understand German. Italians, what else can you expect from them? I did not kill Loretta. Let me give you some good advice, Mr. Adam. Cooperate with me. At this point, you were still among friends. Why are you threatening me? I won't say another word without a lawyer. The older commissario cleared his throat loudly and motioned with his head toward the door. Bueller threw another icy look at Peter, rose to his feet, and left the room. The two commissarios followed him. What now? What was the point of that? They made him wait. Time passed, or it didn't. They had taken his wristwatch. Peter estimated that it was long after midnight. The wait increased his tiredness, but he forced himself to stay alert. At some point, he heard Bueller's voice outside, hollow and loud. He couldn't understand what Bueller was saying, but he sounded upset and angry. Only seconds later, the door flew open and a young woman in a gray suit entered the room, a woman Peter had seen once before. The beautiful Roman woman. My name is Alicia Bertoni, she said without greeting him or paying any mind to his surprise. She presented him with a document and handed him a pen. Sign this and we can go. Who the hell are you? I am your lawyer. Who sent you? I would suggest that we talk about these things outside. Please sign this agreement, Signor Adam. Peter was too baffled to continue arguing. Assuming that Don Luigi had pulled a few strings, he briefly checked the document. It was a representation agreement.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.